Thank you. Just a ray of sunshine. Oh, such delight to watch.
I just can't believe it. It's so lovely seeing that. Because I haven't had time to look at anything.
When did you get? You just got back?
Just got back yesterday, so afternoon.
And how does it feel to be back amongst so many people?
It's really overwhelming. Because you sort of become a bit institutionalised in there. Because as it went on, there were less and less of us. And you really don't engage with anyone apart from your campmates. And then going over that bridge, I was a bit taken aback. I normally am so talkative. And then when it all happened, I didn't have anything to say.
Because you're just totally shell-shocked. Completely. I mean, even arriving back at the airport here in the UK yesterday, I mean, there were so many people there to welcome you in.
Yeah, it was amazing. Fans, I mean, the press as well. I've never had that before. Because, of course, I've been on Made in Chelsea, but this is just a different level. And when I went through arrivals, do you know the kindness of people to come to the airport just to say hi to me?
I'd say, well, you've been in our lives and in our homes every night for the last 3 weeks. So.
Do you know that, and I'm sure somebody has told you, but you topped the phone poll every night on I'm a Celebrity. You were winning it from day one.
I can't believe it, because I really thought no one was going to like me in there. And to hear that, I mean, I don't know what I was worrying about.
No, I know. I mean,
what an honour.
I mean, 71%, that's right, what you said. I mean, that's the biggest sort of gap in the votes that there has ever been.
I just can't. It's quite a lot to take in.
Yeah,
I
bet.
It's so fresh, but...
So what made you want to go in there?
I've never really, because I left school and went straight into Made in Chelsea, I have a lovely, lovely life, but I've never had any challenge or done. My friends went off on their gap years and stuff like that, and I just stayed in London. So I thought when the opportunity arose, I thought, right, go on, do it. See if you can kind of prove to yourself that you are strong. But I never thought I'd do the things that I did in there.
And you said that actually with the challenges, and we spoke to you about this before, how much you surprised yourself, but you do quite quickly become desensitised to the bugs.
You do. I mean, the first one, I don't know how I got through it. I was sweating so much. I was completely traumatised. And by the end, you think, right, I know the green ants are hideous. I know that I can do the snakes now. It is still shocking, you know, because they're all over you, and there's thousands of them. But you do sort of get a bit more used to it.
Yeah.
But I think the only time I saw you, not angry, but perturbed, was when it was made out that the guys should do something because the girls couldn't do it.
Yeah, because at the time it just came out of my mouth. It was one of those, you really forget that there are cameras there, so I didn't think anything of this until I came out and people mentioned it in interviews. Yeah, it does, it's the only thing that grinds my gears, really. I'm so passive. It did, because obviously, biologically, men are bigger, and that's an annoying fact of life in the whole. But doing the jungle has really made me realise that women more than make up for it mentally. And we all really, really did well in there, the girls.
Yeah.
And we all pulled our weight, you know, even, you know, if we are comparing muscles, we did very, very well. So I was quite glad that it was brought up, actually.
Yeah. And then this has sort of set the stage quite nicely for what you'd like to do, because we know that, well, we know that you didn't complete your law degree, as we found out on air, but you do have a natural keen interest in politics, and you would like to use this.
I would like to, because I've spoken about politics a lot over the years, and my main issue that I championed was just general engagement in politics. You know, challenge me on Twitter. If you don't agree with me, great, but tell me why you don't agree with me. And I think sometimes with politics, I think young people particularly become disillusioned with it because they can't relate to it. There's a lot of snobbery. People are a lot older. So I think maybe people shouldn't... Some people do maybe laugh at my interest in politics a tiny bit because reality television doesn't tend to go hand in hand. Maybe the blonde hair and I go out quite a lot.
That's very misjudged, though, of those people who would think that.
Well, this is it. So maybe that is the way forward. Embracing people that might not have an interest might make
you could be our political
more.
Correspondent.
Imagine.
No, I'm imagining.
Trust me.
I've already got the framework of the deal in my head. what's it done for your confidence?
Oh, enormous things. I mean, I've it's been spoken about in the press. I've really struggled with my skin for the best part of 10 years. And if I'm being honest, I kind of hid for the last 4 years on doing television behind makeup. And I never would have admitted that if I was sat here before I did The Jungle. I wear a lot of makeup to cover up my spot. And yes, that is just me.
You don't look like you're... I'm sat opposite now. You don't look like you're wearing a lot of makeup at all.
Thank you. But the amazing thing about The Jungle, I'm obviously allergic to something because my skin hasn't been like this since I was 12 years old. And it's done
an enormous amount.
So maybe it is that sort of clean living, rice and beans or food without additives.
100%. You know, maybe you're allergic to Chelsea. Bugs.
Maybe that's it.
This is going to cause a real problem for you.
I don't want them to come back. But yeah, and I'm glad it's been spoken about in the press. Yes, I did take in foundation, and I'm not ashamed to say that I do cover up my spots. Lots of people get them, but I found it very embarrassing over the years. And really, the only people that have seen me without makeup are my family, best friends and people, flatmates that I've lived with.
Wow.
And I feel a lot more confident as I sit
here
now.
Well, you should do. You're a beauty inside and out.
Bless
you.
Thank you.
We have absolutely loved watching you.
Oh.
A nation fell in love with you. You're adorable.
I can't believe it. Because I was so worried. I remember I was swinging my hammock on the first night and I thought, Georgia, they're not going to like you, these people. And then I was worried about the public and I thought, right, if I'm just myself, no one can question it.
Well, we did.
They like me then.